Boker Tov Chavrim, I'm Stephen Benoon. You're watching Israeli News Live, and we are here in Pensacola, Florida today. Be meeting with some of you later this evening at the Hyatt Hotel. That's right by Pensacola Airport for those of you that want to attend. We do need to know that you're coming though. So please post just a message in the comment section below, because we are limited on our seating here. We already have about 13 coming. So if you're planning on coming, I've got to know you're coming, or else we may not have the ability for you to be able to be here. So we want people to be able to come. So anyway, right now we have 13 people that are coming, and we have space for about another 10, 12, I think 12, I think we're maxed for 25 at this little conference room here. But I wanted to share a couple of things with you real quick before we get started here. 7 o'clock tonight, by the way, Hyatt Hotel, right by Pensacola Airport there. So anyway, interesting article comes out this morning from Reuters news there, and they're talking about Pope Francis tells South Korean faith leaders to promote reconciliation. That sounds like a great thing, all right? I'm not condemning what he's saying. Reconciliation is a great idea, all right? But then again, I got an anonymous email, we'll just say from a sister, Gracious, was a name that was being used on this email. And she sent me this video right here. This is actually, let me just give you who this is being published by. It's being put up by Salt and Light, and it's actually, forget the actual name, Delegation of Rabbis Meet Pope Francis at the Vatican. Perspective Daily is the news coverage that brings this out. Now, what's interesting about this, of course, Pope Francis is giving his condolences for those that are in the flood. That is right where I pick up here, kind of a little further, though. I want to move further along with it. Then the broadcaster goes into Pope Francis talking about the rabbis that came to Rome. Now, this was published, at least on this particular YouTube channel, published on September the 1st. I don't know if it's an older article or not. I've not been able to confirm it as of yet, but rabbis from across Europe and the United States and even Israel, one of the chief rabbinate from Israel, has actually come to Rome for a delegation there. And they show the meeting here, the rabbis there inside of Rome once again. And of course, this is to promote the peace and dialogue once again with Israel and with the Jewish community around the world. Now, it always troubles me when I think about Rome being involved with Israel, because I think about during the time of the Maccabees, yes, they got the temple back, but there's a lot of things the Maccabees did wrong. They ousted the true Levitical priesthood. They replaced it with a false priesthood, which concerns me about the lineage of so-called priests today. But I could not help but think, too, of the famed biblical prophecy here. And let me just share that with you. There's Pope Francis speaking to those rabbis there in Rome. But as we know, too, that whole situation in with Rome, the covenant with Rome and that of Israel back during the time of the Maccabees ended up being a horrible mistake. They did make quote-unquote peace. Well, they sent governors to run Israel, supposedly for their protection. Then eventually they sent the Roman army down, ransacked the Second Temple, dispersed the house of Judah, and they've been gone until modern days. Now, prophecy, though, I thought about as I look at what's going on with the Pope and this promoting of peace with the Jewish people. Jeremiah chapter 6, verse 13, for from the least of them, even to the greatest of them, everyone is given to covetousness. Now, who's he talking about? And from the prophet, even unto the priest, everyone dealeth falsely. All right, so there's not anything going to be good going to be coming out of this type of agreement with Israel and the rabbis. They have healed also the hurt of the daughter of my people, slightly saying, peace, peace, when there is no peace. Now, isn't that interesting? So we could look at this on a global scale as well when the Pope promotes peace, but yet clearly Jeremiah says there is no peace. And yet they go around saying peace, peace, not just about North Korea, but the Middle East in general, and they're healing the hurt of the daughter, which is the future remnant of Israel that returns home. They're healing their pains and everything they're going through. They're hurt slightly, saying peace, peace, but there is no peace. And why? Because Roman armies, even today, are causing all the chaos in the Middle East. So no matter what the mouth speaks, as he says here, the prophet, even unto the priest, everyone dealeth falsely. So we know that they are the ones that are involved in bringing out the lies to the people, and especially the people of Israel, as well as the rest of the world. I'm Stephen Bannoun. Don't forget to be here tonight. Going to share some powerful, incredible things with you. Looking also at geopolitical situation around the world, where are we standing at right now, and just some very interesting inside prophetic information, or maybe I should say revelation, not prophetic, but revelation. I don't get into prophesying about events or anything because I have no idea what the events will be. That's not my calling, but I love to share those insights that God has given to me to share with you. I'm Stephen Bannoun. You're watching Israeli News Live, 7 o'clock tonight, Pensacola, Florida. Don't forget, put it in the comment section below that you are coming. God bless you and thank you. Shalom.